Jesus' promise, where two or more gathered in his name, he's with us. We believe that he is here today. We pray. Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, hear our prayers for your servants, whom you have summoned out of this world. They were brought here against their will, but they served here for the good of others, sacrificing themselves. They lived in search for peace, refreshment, and light. You are the source of all goodness, and they turn to you in their time of suffering. Bring them now to the everlasting glory of heaven, to dwell with you in blessed and eternal light. Just as you promised Abraham and his children, you freed them from slavery. Accept our prayers, for these are loved ones. Though we don't know them by name, we love them as our own. And you have called them to the glory of your mercy and your judgment, which is vindication. Raise them to be with all the saints in glory, to live in your kingdom forever. Lord, we pray for ourselves, that we acknowledge to be their brothers and sisters. We know our human condition, the selfishness of sin, the brevity of our lives on earth. But you created us not to die, but to live forever. We invite you, as St. Paul says, that the bonds of love forged in life are never destroyed in death. May their love for us, their children, and our love for them, our ancestors, unite us always in your peace. We ask this in the name of Jesus, our Lord and Savior. And I'm going to beg the indulgence of everyone here. I'd like to turn this into sacred ground.
Amen.
By a blessing.
Amen.
With holy water.
Amen.
And as I cannot do this alone, I invite everyone please to raise your hands in blessing as well. Lord, you made the holy land the inheritance of Abraham. You blessed it by the blood of those who sacrificed. This land has been made holy by the blood of these slaves. With this water, blessed in the name of Jesus Christ, consecrate this land. Make it holy and inviolable, so that all who rest here will be a sign to us who live to give our lives to you and only you, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
Brother Nelson.
Thank you, baby.
When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing there will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout victory. Give yourself a hand clap.
Hallelujah.
I just want to take this opportunity to thank all of the people here that makes this possible. I want to thank you for inviting us here today to commemorate this great occasion. You're looking at a man right here. It was 1952. I was born on a plantation called Grunyard, right down the road down there. And I tell you, up at the front part of the plantation was where the owner of the plantation lived. And there was this big bell. They would ring this bell early in the morning. That was for the men to get up to go to work. And then if you heard that bell any other time, there was a fire in the quarters. I witnessed fires in the quarters. On June the 4th, just a couple of days ago, I made 68 years old. I know I don't look it, but I thank God for it.
Amen.
But you're looking at a man here that knows a little bit about cemetery. I am a custodian of a cemetery. And there's something about the cemetery headstones. When you go into a cemetery and you look at the headstone, you see the year the person came into the world.
Mm-hmm. Next time we come here, all this conditioning is going to be good right here.
Hey, that's good news.
Yeah, they're going to lay out slab and everything out here.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so we can really enjoy this.
Yeah.
Yeah, and have a tent and everything here.
Yeah.
Y'all speak it?
Yeah.
Y'all declare it?
Yeah.
Yes, it will be.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. You have whatever you say. Amen.
Yeah.
How many know God wanted to be too?
Yeah.
Yeah. We here now under this condition. Amen. Glory to God. And God going to make the condition better.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I just want to, amen, glory to God, share with you what the Lord laid on my heart concerning his commandments. I want, looking at Hebrew, the 11th chapter, because we know they all died in faith.
Amen.
Yes, yes.
They all died in faith. Amen.
Yeah.
Glory
amen.
To God. And that the Bible say that now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things what?
Not seen.
Amen. Glory to God. You know, God will always initiate one thing to accomplish another.
Amen.
You know, our ancestors could have still been in Africa. But God has something on his mind.
Oh, yes.
Amen. You know, even though slavery came about, how many know, glory to God, God allow us to be where we are right now?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know. How many know that we know that all things work together?
For the good.
For the good. To them that love God.
Readable.
And to them that are called to his what? His purpose. God always have a purpose and a predestined.
Yeah.
Forever
yeah.
and ever.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We just thank God. Amen.
Thank
and
you.
We are here. Praise the Lord. And like, amen. At John the 14th chapter, he said, let not your heart be troubled.
Amen.
He said, believe in God, also believing in me. In my Father's house are many dwelling places.
Yes, Lord.
Yeah, we all got a dwelling place there.
Yeah.
Amen. Glory to God. And right now, they're in the grandstand of faith, cheering us on.
Yes, Lord.
Go ahead on, children.
Glory to God.
Carry on the work
Hallelujah.
That we begin.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Yes. Amen. We just thank God. Hallelujah. Glory to God that this is a day that the Lord has made, we will rejoice and be glad in it. Amen.
Amen.
And we commend their bodies to the ground, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. Amen. Glory to God. God bless you. Amen.
Hallelujah.
I sure appreciate you.
Glory to God.
Amen. God bless you.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
All right. Just wanted to say that on February the 1st, a police officer came to my house and told me that Formosa told them to tell me not to come on their property. Well, I'm on here today. See what God can do. See what God can do, huh?
Hallelujah.
They are so angry with me, but I don't care. They didn't want me to put flowers on the graves, but I'm here today to put the roses on the graves. We're going to set them over here. We're going to leave our red roses here. That's for our ancestors. Just want to invite all of you to come to the repast at Welcome Park.
Yes.
We have enough food for everybody. So please come after. When you leave from here, just go straight to Welcome Park.
Amen.
And we're going to close out with our famous song.
Yeah.
Rise St. James theme song is Victory is Mine.
Hallelujah.
Be led by Reverend Joseph.
Amen.
All right.
I want to just say one thing that Paul said is so nice, that the race is not given to the swift. The battle is not given to the strong. But the one that hold out and prove faithful till the end. And we do have a fight, so it's just the beginning. And this day being Juneteenth, we are the people. It's time that we get involved with our Juneteenth and let people know that we are somebody.
Amen.
And how we do that? Victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today. When I rose this morning, I didn't have no doubt. I knew that the Lord will bring me out. I fell down on my knees. I said, Lord, help me, please. I got up singing, shouting, victory. Victory is mine. Victory is mine. Victory today is mine. I told Satan, get thee behind. Victory today is mine. If you got victory, you got peace is mine. I got joy. Joy is mine. Hey, joy is mine. Hey, hey.
Joy today is mine. I chose to get thee behind.
Joy today
is mine.
One more time. When I rose this morning, I didn't have no doubt. I knew that the Lord will bring me out. I fell down on my knees. I said, Lord, help me, please. I got up singing, shouting, victory, victory.
I gotta know how much time I have. I'm serious. What? Know how much time I got? 5 minutes, 10 minutes, what? 5 minutes. Oh, you done took two already. Come on now. Let me say this. There was a man in scripture by the name of Moses. Moses saw a man that was oppressed. That was a man that was representative of his people. He saw a man that was beaten down. And then God raised Moses up. And God said to Moses, you are to go down to old Pharaoh and tell Pharaoh, let my people go. Yeah. Somebody say, let my people go. I want you for a minute to look where we're standing. Yeah. We're standing beside a fence with barbed wire on it. The audacity. Somebody say, let my people go. The audacity that you would pin us in. The audacity that you would threaten us with barbed wire. But it's no different than what's been taking place for centuries. They tried to hem the people in, to those who were enslaved. They said, you will not go free. And we will put you, take your life. We will whip you and beat you and maim you, put scars on you just like that barbed wire if you try to get free. But here's what I want you to know. If somebody truly want to get free, they're going to get free.
Amen.
They're going to get free.
Yes.
There were a whole bunch of the enslaved that got free. They got free.
Hallelujah.
And we're going to get our freedom too.
Amen.
We ain't fully gotten it yet, but we're going to get it.
Yes,
and we're going to get it on behalf of those whose blood, sweat, and tears have soaked this ground right here.
Yes,
we're going to get it for them.
Yes.
Because we owe them a debt of gratitude.
Yes.
We owe them a shout of thank you.
Yes. Yes.
For what they did.
Yes.
I drip sweat from me that adds to the ground today. I drip my same perspiration for them today on this land. See, I'm only here for an hour.
Yes.
But they were here from sun up to sundown.
Yes, Lord.
Working these fields in this arid, humid heat of southern Louisiana from 6 o'clock in the morning to 6 in the evening. Black
lives matter.
Amen.
But they didn't matter to the, those who enslaved them. They never mattered unless they were bringing productivity and generational wealth into this country. Exactly. That is why we must stand here.
Yes.
That is why I must drip my sweat on these same blood and sweat-stained ground.
Yeah, right.
And I tell you this right now, and I'm overcome today. I'm so overjoyed.
Yeah. Jesus.
God is on our side.
Yes, yes.
Do you feel him? God is on our side. And if he be for us, then who can be against us? There is no devil in hell that can defeat us. Although that devil may be called by the name Formosa, that devil may be called by the name DuPont Dinka, that devil may have many other names such as chloroprene and ethylene. It may have many names. But my God said, at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. Every tongue shall confess. God told me that he's got this. We saw him moving on yesterday. We saw him moving on today. We saw him moving on last week. God says you better step on every part of that ground. You better start the stomping right now. Because God told Moses, you're going to go and you're going to conquer some enemies. And Formosa, you have been declared an enemy. Because God said, let my people let them go. And you can't hold them, Formosa. Those who came before us and those who will come after us, you can't hold them. So just like God told Moses, like God told Joshua, I'm going to give you every place that your feet touches. And Joshua got to stomping.
Yes.
He said, God, you gonna give, you said every place. You mean every place, oh God, not just some places. I don't care about no B, not just some places. I'm gonna give you every place. I tell you today, get to stomping.
Yes, get
to stepping.
Yes.
The young people used to say, you better get to stepping.
Yes, right.
Hallelujah.
For most of you better get to stepping. Because we about to step.
Yes, yes.
Y'all ain't stopping. You better step on this ground right here. We know it's holy, so we know it's sacred, so just tread lightly. We got to do this in a cool spirit.
Oh, yeah.
But we stepping now.
Yes.
God said he's going to give us every land.
Yes, sir.
He's going to give it to us.
Yes.
And I proclaim like Miss Sharon has been saying, God already told me.
Hallelujah.
God already told me. It's mine.
Yes.
So here's the end of my sermon. Shortest sermon I ever preached, but it sounds good. God said to Moses, what's in your hand, Moses? What's in your hand? Use what you got. Use what you got. You're going to start seeing some miracles. Use what you got. Pharaoh will listen to you. It may take some time, but what's in your hand, Moses? I'm going before you. And Moses said, God, if you don't go before me, then don't send me up from this place.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
Don't send me up from this place. And God said, my name is I Am. Tell him the great I Am sent you.
Amen.
I'm right there beside you. I will go with you. And Moses said, we all good then. We all straight then. We're good. And Moses said, now God, show me your glory.
Hallelujah.
Show me your, somebody say, show me.
Show me
your glory.
Your glory.
Moses said, I want to see what you do.
Yes, Lord.
I want to see what you can do. Because I'll be sure to give you all the glory.
Yes, Lord.
All the praise and all the honor. Somebody say, show me
your glory.
Show me your glory. Now, as I end, here's what I want to do. I want to do a thank you chorus. And what that means is I want everybody to shout just thank you, but I don't want you to do it all at once. I want you to be moved by the Spirit.
Jesus.
I want you to feel the Spirit that is moving. And my nose running, I'm snotting, I need a Kleenex. Anybody got something for me? You better stop laughing. Come on now. I'm about to use this mask if y'all don't help me out right here. Just the Kleenex, that's all I need. I don't need to be on the news. Thank you. I knew you weren't quick enough, Sylvia. I love you, but here's what I got to say. We want to do a thank you chorus. So you're going to just shout out thank you as loud as you can. But what you got to do is be in tune with each other and sense when there's that moment for you. And so we just want you to sense it. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. As loud as you can, because we're going to thank God for this moment right here. There's a shifting right now.
Yes, it is.
There's a movement right now. You can't feel it, but God is shaking the earth.
So you just start to say thank you as loud as you can when I say one, two, three. But don't try to say it on top of anybody. Let it be your own thank you.
Yes, sir.
And let God know that where it's welling up from.
Yes.
So y'all start, and we're going to do that for about, it should only take us about 10, 15 seconds. But you sense when your turn is. Here we go. One, two, three.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you. Thank you.